knapper, maar ja. As a teacher, have you implemented any lessons through distance learning for learners?
Walaikum salam Ziad. Gee, alhamdulillah, we have implemented lessons. We started this, well, in fact, we started today. Our platform, which we've been using for a while now, is been, well, today's platform has been through WhatsApp. That's our distance learning platform in the meantime. Alhamdulillah, it was quite successful with our parents. I'm a grade 2 teacher, so I've had parents on the group and delivering lessons via videos and via voice recordings and sending the PDFs out. So alhamdulillah, that has been quite successful thus far.
Papa, you mentioned you've used WhatsApp. Is there any other platforms that have been used?
Yes, there's quite a few platforms. Many of my colleagues in different schools have also implemented other platforms of distance learning. Google Classroom, Google Slides. Our bigger grades have been using Zoom since last week. That has been very successful with our kids. I have a daughter in grade 11, and she's had found tremendous success with it because they log in at a certain time and they have contact with their teacher and they can speak to their teacher. Well, not face to face, but it's live. So that is effective. Other schools have used other platforms like there's another one, I'm not sure, I think it's called e-classroom or e-learning. And there's so many others that you can actually take on and check. But for the smaller grades, the WhatsApp has been working well.
And what do you find challenging about distance learning as compared to that of teaching in a classroom?
Oh, well, the first challenge I can honestly say is I really miss my class. I miss my children. I just miss interacting with them. You know, the human interaction and that human connection which you have with your learners as a teacher is something that you can't explain to anybody. If you're a teacher, you'll know what I'm talking about. And to all my teacher friends, you all are feeling the same frenzy. We're all in this together. But the main thing which I find challenging is that if I have a child that I've delivered a lesson to over the WhatsApp, for example, and I have a learner that finds certain concepts challenging, then that won't just cover it. It won't be enough for that learner. So you don't have that interaction with that learner. So you need to actually maybe make a video call and explain it to the child, make an arrangement with a parent. Because there are learners that actually need this hands-on learning, and this does not suffice completely for them. So it would be unfair to say that it's beneficial for all learners, you know. But alhamdulillah, we've taken baby steps. It's our first time doing distance learning, and inshallah, we will improve along the way. By next year, if we have to go a further route or whenever it is, I think we'll be pros at it.
Papa, last question. I'm a parent and I haven't given my son a cell phone until today. He's like 9 years old already. Am I forced to give him that cell phone now because there's a fight at home now? Whose cell phone is going to use, the mother's or the father's?
Okay. Now, as far as that goes, I have an 11-year-old, so I know what you're speaking about. I'm also in the same boat. I had a cell phone laying around. I got a SIM card, which I installed onto that phone because I'm a teacher and I have to deliver my own lessons. So it is a problem, and I understand that. My child also doesn't have a cell phone. He's turning 11 this year. However, you as a parent have to take cognizance of the fact that this is important for him now. So you'll have to monitor when his lessons are being delivered onto the groups. And as a parent, you and your wife will have to work together to see how you're going to monitor it. You're not going to give him the cell phone to have free use of it, basically. You're not going to give him that. No, that free reign is not there. The cell phone is limited just for his classwork and for him to do his work for the day, basically. But you as a parent, it's up to you to make up your mind and decide how and when you're going to allow your child to use that phone.
Ameen.